Hello friends, in this video we shall see the concept of cookies in a PHP web application. So what is a cookie? It essentially is a text file that is stored on the client's computer, and so that every time when the client visits the web application or the server on which the web application is hosted, those cookies are transmitted or sent to the server along with any data that the client's computer might send to the server. So the cookies are transmitted when the client's browser, you know, comes into contact with the web server through the web application. So that these are the text files, or this data that is stored in the cookies is useful for the web server or the web application to provide a better response to the client for the subsequent events or subsequent actions or subsequent visits that the client may have. So that is essentially targeted or used to provide a better experience of browsing to the client. That's why the cookies are created. Now, these are the three steps involved in identifying the returning users. When the user returns, what happens? The server side script sends a certain set of cookies, and those cookies are deposited in the browser in the form of example name. For example, the name, age, or the identification number, etc. These are some of the examples of the cookies that may be stored in the client. The browser stores the information on the local machine. When for the first time when the client comes into contact with the server, server introduces a certain cookies, and those cookies will be stored by the browser in the client's machine. Next time when the same client, you know, communicates with or comes into contact with or browses the same server, same web page or same web application, next time when the browser sends any request, along with the any request, the web server also receives the cookies information that is stored in the browser on the earlier stage. Okay, so what happens? The server now has an information of the previous visit of the same client, and then accordingly a better, you know, service can be provided to the client in the subsequent visits. Cookies are usually set on the inside the HTTP header. Cookies are usually set in the header itself. Sometimes a certain JavaScript code also can be used to set a cookie directly on the browser. A PHP script which sets a cookie might send the data back to the client, which will be something of this type. For example, HTTP 1.1 is the current version of HTTP protocol that is being used. The date on which it is set, the server type of server software that you are using, which cookie is set, set cookie name is equal to XYZ, expires, what is the expiry that is prescribed on it, path, the name of the server, domain name, connection close, etc. So this is a typical cookie that is inserted. Cookie header contains the name value pair, like here you can see cookie name and value, and the date on which it is set and the expiry. The name and value will be URL encoded. The expires field is essential in the sense how much time should the client go on to hold on to the cookie data that can be prescribed by the expiry date. So all these data will be stored inside the client's computer, which will be transmitted from the server. And next time, the client will transmit this cookie back to the server. Now, how to do this? And how the PHP does this? And for that, there is a function called as setCookie. The setCookie function is used to set a cookie inside the client. This function requires 6 arguments and should be called before the HTML tag. When the actual construction of web page starts with the HTML tag. Before that it should be used. Okay, what are the arguments? Name, value, these are the two essential ones. Expire, when does the cookie will expire? Path, domain and security. We have seen these fields in the example that I just showed you. Name, the name of the cookie, which is available in a variable, environment variable called as HTTP cookie vars. Var means variables. Value, the value associated with the cookie. Expiry, you can specify the future time in seconds when the cookie will expire. Path, directories for which the cookie is valid. Domain, specifies the domain name. Two very large domains. It must contain at least two periods, like www.tutorials.com, at least two dots must be present. And the security. Default security is normal. If you want to specify HTTPS security, set this security to 1. Okay, so these are the parameters that has to be sent to the setCookie method. Once the cookie is set, how to read back? In order to access the cookies from the PHP script, you can use either $_cookie variable, which is also a part of the request variable that we saw, and or you can use $HTTP cookie vars variables. Both contain the data regarding data relating to the cookies. You can execute it or you can access it. You can also use an isSet function. For what? To verify whether a particular cookie has been set or not. So, isSet function can be used before actually executing or using this $_cookie. Because otherwise what may happen? You may try to find out or access the value from that associative array, a data belonging to a variable which is not set at all. So it is always better to use isSet first. If it is true, then access the cookie. So all these three can be used. And finally, to delete a cookie, to do what? Actually, there is no function to delete a cookie. There is a setCookie function to set a cookie. To read a cookie, you have the cookie associative array. In order to delete, the way around is to set a date, which is set an expiry date, which has already happened. A previous date, if you set as a value of the expiry date, then the cookie will be deleted. So, what is a cookie? What does it do? How the cookie is transmitted, how the cookie is set, how the cookie is read, and how it is to be deleted. All these three, these different concepts. Now, we will have a composite example of all these three. We will have a first code which will set the cookie. It will tell you that the cookie has been set, and then run another code which will read back the cookie and display it to you that the value of the cookie was this. So, all these three different mechanisms that I will show you with the help of a composite example displaying all these three activities. So, this is the example.
So, here now I will demonstrate the way in which a cookie is set and cookie is retrieved in PHP. Actually, I will show you three different codes. One is the HTML form. Second is the PHP script which will set the cookie, and the third is the PHP script which will read back the cookies. So, starting with the HTML form, the name of the HTML page is cookieform.html. All it has is a simple form in which two text elements are there and the method is post. The form data is sent by using the post method to a PHP script called as setCookie.php. When you press the submit button, the data will be directed towards the setCookie.php. So, what is there in the setCookie.php? This is that PHP script. So, all we are doing is fetching the form data by using the $_post associative array. Remember that the HTML elements were having the names as name and age. So these are the keys. The values associated are retrieved and stored in the two variables nm and age. So use those variables to set the cookie. The syntax of set cookie function is set cookie, the name of the cookie and the value. Okay, the name of the cookie and value. Here you are setting the time interval, the URL and the other parameters as explained in the earlier discussion. So those two cookies will be set. It will just give a message, cookies are set, and then it will give you an hyperlink. If you click that, this getCookie.php will be opened. That is having a code to read back the cookies. So this is the getCookie.php. What it does, it simply finds the value associated with the name key of the dollar underscore cookie associative array, that is a part of the request server variable. So from which the cookie name and cookie age are fetched and they are displayed. So whichever values that you may have given in the earlier form, they will be read back. So these are the three different codes. One is the HTML form, other is the set cookie script, third is the get cookie script. I'll show all these three activities in front of you by running starting from the cookieform.html. So this cookieform.html contains two text elements. Let us enter some data into it and press the submit button. What happens? The form will take the data back to a PHP script called setCookie.php. The two cookies will be set. Right? Now there is a hyperlink which takes me to the getCookie.php which reads back the values. So these are the two values. So this is a small but effective example of setting and retrieving the cookies in PHP.